Hello, I'm Dr. Nagesh Shetty, consultant cardiologist at Manipal Hospital, Malleshwaram and Old Airport Road. Today is the World Heart Day. Cardiovascular diseases, they remain the world's number one killer, resulting in nearly 19 million deaths worldwide every year. 29th of September every year celebrated as a World Heart Day. The aim is to create awareness in the society about prevention and also the management of cardiovascular diseases. As far as the prevention is concerned, it takes a back seat. We have enough of gadgets in the armamentarium for investigations and treatment. Maybe it is a medications, an angioplasty or a cobalt therapy, a CT scan, innumerable number are available. But when it comes to prevention, it boils down to the individual. If a person suffers a heart attack, tens and hundreds of relatives, they meet me or call me, inquiring about the appropriate medications, about an angiogram or angioplasty. Irony is, hardly anyone of them I have come across who is inquiring about a periodic checkups or a regular follow-up of the same patient. You invite 10 people for a drink party to a hotel or a club. Chances that actually 12 or 13 people may turn up. The same people you call for them early morning cycling or swimming, hardly one or two may turn up. Here also the prevention takes a back seat. The theme for this year's World Heart Day is Use Your Heart to Connect. Probably this has a lot of meaningful implications, including connecting with the patients digitally. In my opinion, it implies connect your patients with empathy. COVID pandemic has made a major impact on the healthcare sector over the last 2 years. Apart from draining the healthcare resources, it has created a panic among non-COVID patients for seeking timely medical help. Telehealth, digital health, they have played a key role and entered the main arena during this period, connecting the patient and doctor at the click of a button. Video consultations, teleconsultations, telereporting, remote monitoring of cardiac devices, the future of healthcare sector is going to be digital and more digital. So, on this occasion of a World Heart Day, I would like to demystify certain myths about cardiovascular diseases. Number one myth, heart disease means heart attack only. Apart from heart attack, there are congenital heart disease. Heart attack is, to be in a simple terms, it's a mismatch between the oxygen demand and supply to the heart muscle due to blockages in the coronary heart arteries which supply the heart muscle. Apart from this, we have a congenital heart diseases which are known as birth defects and rheumatic heart disease which predominantly involves the valves, and there are cardiomyopathies. There is a disease of heart muscles which can be genetic or following the viral infections which causes the heart muscle dysfunction, and there are arrhythmias also, which are the electrical disturbances of the heart wherein the heart rate may go below a critical level, or it may go up a critical level, causing heart muscle dysfunction. So each of them requires a different approach and a different management strategies. Then the second myth is heart attack present only with a chest pain. Please note that all chest pains are not heart attacks, and every heart attack need not present as a chest pain. It can present as a gastritis, belching, a bloating of the abdomen, recurrent vomiting. You can have a shoulder pain or both arm pains or hand pains, rarely as a jaw pain or a toothache, and back pain, upper back pain on a gradient walking, shortness of breath, unusual tiredness or sweating, and a giddiness. So these atypical symptoms, like which are not presenting as a chest pain, are more commonly seen in diabetics, women, and elderly patients. Third myth is a normal ECG rules out heart attack or a heart disease. One can have a near normal ECG despite having a critical blockages in the coronary arteries, or one can have a significant valvular disease, or one can have a low ejection fraction, whereas in the pumping efficiency becomes low. In such scenarios, additional investigations may be required, like a blood test, cardiac enzymes, like troponin I, echocardiography, exercise ECGs like a treadmill, CT angiography, invasive angiography, and a cardiac MRI. All these may be required to diagnose and treat heart condition appropriately. I will seek a medical help next day morning or when time permits. This is the fourth myth. Please note that time is muscle. Each minute heart muscle dies after a heart attack. Report to the hospital as early as possible once the symptoms begin, because first hour is a golden hour. First 3 hours is a very crucial period. 6 hours is also a reasonable time to reach a hospital. 12 hours, it's a questionable. In 24 hours, it causes irreversible damage to the heart muscle. Nothing much can be done. And one more myth is, medications can be discontinued after angioplasty or a bypass or a control of blood pressure. With a post-procedure or surgery, medications need a readjustment. And these medications need to be taken for a long term or maybe lifelong. One may land up in a hospital with a stroke, heart attack, heart or a kidney failure after a discontinuation of BP medication. Hypertension. High BP is a silent killer. So, coming to the risk factors of ischemic heart disease, the commonest are high BP, which is the most silent disease or the most silent killer, uncontrolled diabetes, smoking or tobacco consumption, sedentary lifestyle, sitting is the new smoking, and high cholesterol. Apart from this, we have a family history of cardiovascular diseases, wherein if both the parents are affected, the chances of having cardiovascular disease is high in the children. Lack of sleep. 6 to 7 hours of quality sleep is a must. Obstructive sleep apnea. Snoring is not a sign of a sound sleep. Snoring suggests a sleep apnea, so seek a medical help with a pulmonologist. Indoor-outdoor pollutions. They are very important cardiovascular risk factor. And we also noticed that most of the heart attacks follow viral infections of respiratory disease or a bacterial infection of urinary tract. So what are the preventive measures? Diet. So when it comes to diet, quality and quantity of food matters. Keep an eye on your calorie intake and expenditure. A cup of ice cream has 10 times of calories of one chapati. So please limit 3S and 3R. They are saturated fat, salt, sugar, refined food, reboiled food, and recooked food. Also avoid canned and tin foods because they are high in the salt content. Coming to the physical activity, 45 minutes of daily walking at least 6 days a week is a must. Take a stairs wherever it is possible. Avoid sitting constantly at a place for more than 2 hours. As I mentioned, sitting is the new smoking. Add meditation or mental relaxation techniques to your regime. Sleep. A sound sleep rejuvenates mind and body. Humans sleep about one third of their lives asleep. Yet most individuals, they know very little about the sleep. Something is there called circadian rhythm, which refers collectively to daily rhythm in the physiology of the body, behavior of the body, which controls the sleep-wake cycle. Modulate the physical activity and food consumption. Over a course of day, they also regulate the body temperature, the heart rate, muscle tone, and the hormone secretion, which are all very important for the harmonious functioning of the body. Apart from this, proper control of diabetics, proper control of high blood pressure, even most importantly, go for a periodic health checkup. Prevention is always better than cure. Thanking you all. Wish you all very happy, healthy living on this occasion of World Heart Day. Thank you once again.